Hi guys, welcome to our new video. This is Azania Tutorials, and we would like to thank you for supporting us all the time, and please don't forget to subscribe. You're gonna enjoy this video. The reason why I made this video, I spent a lot of time trying to install phpMyAdmin on Kali Linux. I'm a guy who has been using Ubuntu and also I've been using Windows for so long, so on Kali Linux I got some challenge, and then I say no, this pain, there is somebody who's like me somehow somewhere who wants to learn how to do this. So to not waste a lot of time for you guys, you're gonna see here, we say look, go to your browser, type in this, you're gonna see this is what's gonna happen. Anyway, if you wanna do this, click here and go to Google. Google is your friend, you know, so type in phpMyAdmin download, then you click there, then you click on this first site, then after you're gonna click this, you click on download, click and you go to your downloads. I downloaded this already, so I don't want to do something sort of like a waste. After that, you go to click to your folder and go to downloads, and when you in downloads, you got to, let me go home, I'm gonna go to downloads back. Yeah, this is the file, so you right click, this is the wrong file. I think I put it here, the file which we need to get. We're gonna get phpMyAdmin. It's not Android Studio. Anyway, if we don't get that, simply means we're gonna put it there. So we go back, we download a new file, click there, it will ask you, then you say save. Donate, say close the donate button, then you say download, say okay, then you say okay. Once you say okay, the download is here, so it's done downloading. So what you're gonna do, we're gonna click, but if you wanna donate, please do donate, because these guys, they do a lot of work, and you can come here, you can see we have our zip folder here. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna click here, right click, and we do extract here. So after extraction, you can see this is the file we have here. So you go open your command prompt and you say clear. Okay, I think you can see everything, guys. I created some documentation on how to do this. I'm gonna be using that, and we're gonna proceed. So what you have to do now, you have to, let me get my document here. So we have to extract. Yes, we did extract. So but now we have to move that to something, to another folder. This folder, we're gonna put it to this folder. You can see this folder. Yes, that's the folder we're gonna do. So what you do, you go here and right click here and also say like rename. So what we need to do is to copy this. You copy this line, say copy. After copying that, so you go to your terminal and you say MV, which stands for move. We're moving that to. Then you paste that. This is what we're gonna move. Then you put / space, then space / USR / share, then / phpMyAdmin. You copy that. You put phpMyAdmin. Then you press enter. You say move cannot do what? I wonder why this didn't work. Okay, but we're gonna see why. So, okay. There's no search file on the directory. So I wonder why it's doing this. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna copy this entire thing. We're gonna put this and we copy exactly the way it is. We come and press enter. Still we're getting the same thing. Say what long. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. So we have to cd to downloads. Downloads. Then you enter. When we in downloads, that's when we're going to type move this line. So then you say enter. Yes. Now we 100% sure we managed to move this file to this. So after that, you're going to use this line. I don't want to spend a lot of time for you. You can pause the video to see the line. It says CHOWN minus capital R WW dash, like you see the way you see it. Then you press enter. After that, you go to another line, which I'm copying here. You put it here, you paste it there, pause the video, try to watch, see everything clear to you. You press enter. Okay, it seems like everything's going well. So now it say create Apache configuration file for phpMyAdmin. So it simply means you're gonna create a file you go to etc Apache 2 config available, then you create a file. It's gonna be called this. This is the file which you're going to create. So what you do, you go to yes, let me show you here. What you're gonna do, you go to etc whereby you go to yes, let me click. I want everybody to see everything. You click to other, you go to computer, you go to etc, you look for etc, go there. Yes, we here. In etc you go to Apache 2, you click there. Then in there, there's a folder called config available. So this is the folder. We click in there. So there's a this folder, this thing. The file called phpMyAdmin.config. So that you open that, then you copy and paste this information. You see this information. This is the information you need. So you can pause the video and see what kind of information you have to type in. This is what you need to type in. So what I'm gonna do, I copy the information I'm gonna bring in. If there's no file like that, what you're gonna do, you're gonna copy it and paste it there. I'm sorry about that, guys. So what you're gonna do, copy that and put it there, because we have to make sure this is the same information. I copy and put it here. So after that, you save the file. After saving the file, you close. Okay, it seems like everything is going well. So but now you need to do this. You need to move to write this line, the last line. So the last line is gonna be like this. The last line is sudo ln minus small space minus small s space forward slash usr forward slash share forward slash phpMyAdmin forward slash space forward slash var forward slash ww forward slash http html forward slash phpMyAdmin. So you hit enter. Oh, if everything's fine there, then it simply means we're done. Let me see, let me test what we want to do. So remember here what we saw, this is what we saw, but now let's see. Yes, we're here. So since we're here, we just say root, that's your root, and then root. You say okay. Yeah. Guys, thanks for watching. I think everyone is happy about the video. If I made some mistakes, please guys help me. and comment. Please don't forget to subscribe. This is the way you install phpMyAdmin on Kali Linux. Whatever step you didn't see, make sure you do what? You pause the video and repeat. It took me almost 2 days to see how this thing works, because I got a lot of examples on YouTube, but they did not work for me. I hope this worked for you guys, and please recommend our videos, share our videos, and like our videos. Yeah, thanks for watching. Bye bye. See you in the next video.